If you wish to learn the laws of refraction in class 8, you need to clear one conception. Let me start with that. If this be a right angle triangle, suppose this triangle is right angle at A, other two angles are always acute angles. Angle C and angle B are always acute angles, remember. You know this. Angle ABC and angle ACB are always acute angles. Their values may be same, then these two angles will be 45 degree each. This can be 60 degree, so that will be 30 degree. If this be 75 degrees, then it will be 15 degrees. This way, these two angles, the other two angles than the right angle, are always acute angles, each of them. Now, if the ongoing discussion tells about this angle, for example, then its opposite side, AB, will be perpendicular. If the discussion tells about this angle, angle ABC, then its opposite side, AC, will be perpendicular. For example, let us take this angle, angle ACB, or in short, angle C. So this is perpendicular. The side adjacent to the concerned angle, this is the concerned angle now, as we have talked about angle ACB or angle C. So the side adjacent to the angle is the base, and the side opposite to the right angle is always hypotenuse. These three are the names of the sides. If anybody talks about this angle, then base will be changed to perpendicular at that time, and the side adjacent to that angle will be base. Now I have taken this angle as the concerned angle. What can be done here? We can find out the ratio of any two sides. Ratio between AB by ABC, or AB by AC, or AC by BC. These three ratios, at least these three ratios, can be determined. Opposites are also true, BC by AB, AC by AB, BC by AC, also true. But for beginning, let us discuss these three ratios, AB by BC. AB by BC means perpendicular by hypotenuse for this angle, for angle C. When this ratio is determined, this is called sine angle C, sine C, or simply sine C. This is called sine, S-I-N-E, sine. The name of this ratio is sine. AC by BC means base by hypotenuse. Base by hypotenuse, the name of this ratio is cos, cos C, capital. This is actually cosine. This ratio is cosine. Remains left AB by AC, that is perpendicular by base. The name of this ratio is tangent C, tan C. Three other ratios are possible: hypotenuse by perpendicular, hypotenuse by base, and base by perpendicular. But that is not, these ratios, the other three ratios are not our concern at this time. We will learn in due course. Even we will not be worried about tan C and cos C. Only we need sin C. Means the sin ratio. Maybe sin B. In this case, as in as I have told, my concerned angle is C, so sin C. But we will confine ourselves with this ratio perpendicular by hypotenuse in case of laws of refraction. Now let us move into the laws of refraction. Here I have shown a light is traveling through this medium. Say this is optically rarer medium and this is optically denser medium, and this is the surface of separation between these two media. At this point on the separation of surface of separation, this point, at this point the light is striking, so this is the point of incidence. Let this point be denoted by O and the name of the ray suppose AO. If you drop a perpendicular at this point, you know the name of this perpendicular is normal. Suppose the name of the normal is here in this case in indus. This rare medium is for example air, and the denser medium for example is water or glass. In my example, this is water. While traveling from rarer to denser medium, the light will come closer to the normal. The angle between the normal and the ray of incidence is angle of incidence. Angle between the ray of refraction and the normal is angle of refraction. See, the ray of incidence at the point of incidence, the normal and the ray of refraction all lie on the same plane. This was law 1, first law. Second law, for a given pair of media, here my media are air and water, given pair of media, their optical densities are also different. Ratio of the sine of angle of incidence, if we drop a perpendicular from here to the angle of incidence, then if this be the angle of incidence, this is the angle of incidence, its opposite side, this one, divided by, this is the perpendicular, so this angle is right angle, so that is hypotenuse. So this side divided by this side, sine I. So that will be sin I. So you can understand from our previous discussion. And if you drop a perpendicular from here also on the ray of refraction, so this side will be the perpendicular and that is the hypotenuse. So ratio between these two will be sin R. These two, this ratio sin I by sin R is always constant. And this is denoted by one Greek letter mu, mu, a mu, mu. I have told that drop a perpendicular from a point on the normal to the ray of incidence. From which point? Here, there, where? And from which point? This side. There is a rule. If you draw a circle by taking one radius, any radius, suppose this is the radius, if you draw a circle like this, this circle would intersect ray of refraction as well as the ray of incidence. You have to drop a perpendicular from this point on the normal, and here from this point on the normal. This is the rule. Not randomly from here or there, not as per our choice. If we draw a circle by taking the point of incidence as the center of that circle and any radius, this side and that side will be same. In that case, any radius from the normal, if you draw a circle, the circle will definitely intersect the angle ray of incidence and ray of refraction. From those two points of incident, points of intersection, drop two perpendiculars on the normal, as I have shown here. Then that will be the perpendicular in case of angle of incidence, perpendicular by hypotenuse, perpendicular by hypotenuse in that case. Whatever be the case, the sin I by sin r, this ratio will always be constant, always be constant. And that constant is denoted by mu. This is the second law. This is called Snell's law. Remember, for given two sets, given a pair of two different media, here if air and water is always taken, for example, and whatever be the radius, this small, that one, whatever be the length of the radius, always this value will remain same, that's why constant, for a given set of media. For example, x dash is the surface of separation, AO is the ray of incidence at point O. Let us draw the normal by protractor or the set square. By setting the set square like this, draw a normal through the point of incidence, n dash be the normal. Now, if the ray of refraction is this, OB, draw a circle by taking O as the center with any radius on the normal. See, the circle is intersecting both the ray of incidence and the ray of refraction. So this be the point P and that be the point Q, these two points of intersection. Draw perpendiculars from these two points to the normal by setting the set square like this. PR be that perpendicular from this point. This is the angle of incidence. So PR is the perpendicular and OP is the hypotenuse. This is right angle. Similarly, from point Q also, drop a perpendicular to the normal drawn. QS is that perpendicular in my drawing. R is the angle of incidence, so QS is the perpendicular and OQ is the hypotenuse. So here sin I is equal to PR by OP and sin R perpendicular by hypotenuse SQ by OQ. Therefore sin I by sin R can be written as PR by OP by SQ by OQ. See, OQ and OP are the radii of this circle, OQ and OP. So these two are same, will be cancelled, and you have PR by SQ, the length of these two perpendiculars, length, centimeter, millimeter, whatever. So that unit will be cancelled. You have a number only. Increase the radius, decrease the radius, you will have the same value. Suppose it is 2 is to 1 or 2. 2 is to 1 means 2. Or 2 by 3 or 5 by 4, whatever. One value you will get every time by increasing or decreasing the size of the radius, you will get the same value for these two media. Suppose this is air and that is glass. So long as these two are the media, you will have the same value everywhere. Every time, if you increase or decrease the radius and draw the circle, draw perpendicular, whatever. Wish to write symbolically refractive index of water, speed of light in vacuum by speed of light in water. If we are told that refractive index of water is 1.33, what does it mean? It is C by SW, as we have used the symbols. So C is equal to, that is speed of light in vacuum is equal to 1.33 into speed of light in water. So in that case, speed of light in vacuum is 1.33 times faster than that in water.